Tyndale community, hear these words from Psalm 80. Restore us, Lord God Almighty. Make your face shine on us that we may be saved.
We gather this morning because we are God's people. Day by day, we praise the living God. We are a community in Christ Jesus. In praise, in prayer, in teaching and fellowship, we are sustained by our Lord. This morning, let us worship our God. Good morning, welcome to Community Chapel for those of you who are here in person, and for those of you who are tuning in online, either live or on demand, welcome. This morning and this week are significant times in the history of Canada. It was just this past summer that the government of Canada declared that September 30th from here on in would be National Day of Truth and Reconciliation, in memory, in respect, in honor, and in Canada's difficult past, particularly with our Indigenous people, First Nations, Métis, and Inuit, especially in relation to the residential school systems. Today, we are hoping to have Dr. Terry LeBlanc with us. And I say hoping because Dr. LeBlanc is actually calling in from Prince Edward Island, and he's had all sorts of internet problems this morning. So we're still hoping that he will be able to join us. If he doesn't, we will certainly have his message available for everyone at a later time. He will record it for us, and we'll be able to share it with you. If he is here, we'll be able to hear him as he speaks. And then this coming Thursday, the actual National Day of Truth and Reconciliation, we are very pleased to have Mr. Andrew Thunder join us in a pre-recorded message. And we'll gather back here in the chapel and online at 10:15 on that day in solemn reflection and recollection of what this day means. So today, let us join our hearts together as we come together as a community, in person and online, to think through what it means to be a country and a community that seeks forgiveness and reconciliation by telling truths and sharing our stories. Let's pray together. Triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we come before you as many parts of a single body, people drawn from every tribe, every nation, every language, some indigenous peoples of the land, some refugees, immigrants, pilgrims, people on the move, some hosts, some guests, some both hosts and guests, all of us searching for an eternal place where we can belong. Creator, forgive us. The earth is yours and everything that is in it, but we forget. In our arrogance, we think we own it. In our greed, we think we can steal it. In our ignorance, we worship it. In our thoughtlessness, we destroy it. We forget that you created it to bring praise and joy to you, that you gave it as a gift for us to steward, for us to enjoy, for us to see more clearly your beauty and your majesty. Jesus, save us. We wait for your kingdom. We long for your throne. We hunger for your reconciliation, for that day when people from every tribe and every tongue will gather around you and sing your praises. Holy Spirit, teach us. Help us to remember that the body is made up of many parts, each one unique and everyone necessary. Teach us to embrace the discomfort that comes from our diversity and to celebrate the fact that we are unified, not through our sameness, but through the blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Triune God, we love you. Your creation is beautiful, your salvation is merciful, and your wisdom is beyond compare. We pray all of this in the name of Jesus. Amen. As Dr. Kerr has reminded us several times in the last 12 months or so at significant events here at Tyndale University, we are on land that is not our own. And as such, given the nature and the theme of this week's chapels, we think it would be appropriate to again acknowledge the land that we are upon. For thousands of years, the Greater Toronto Area has been the traditional land of the Huron-Wendat, the Seneca, and most recently the Mississaugas of the Credit River. It is part of the Dish with One Spoon territory, a treaty between the Anishinaabe, Mississaugas, and Haudenosaunee that committed them together to share the territory and protect the land. Other Indigenous peoples and nations have subsequently entered this territory in the spirit of peace, friendship, and respect. It is on these lands and in this spirit that Tyndale University seeks to engage in its work.
Let's stand together as we worship the God who is sovereign over our earth.
This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and around me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's.
Fire beside me.
our God. Please be seated.
Please pray with me. Loving God, you have reconciled us in Christ Jesus, and you have given us the ministry of reconciliation. We pray for all those from whom we are estranged. Bring healing to strained or broken relationships. Forgive us for the times we have wronged others, whether by ignorance, neglect, or intention. And grant us the courage and the grace to seek their forgiveness and opportunities to make amends. Where others have wronged us, grant us a gracious spirit, that we might forgive, even as we have been forgiven in Christ Jesus. Amen. Today's scripture passage is taken from the book of 2 Peter, Chapter 1, 1 through 11, and I'm reading from the New International Version. Simon Peter, a servant and apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who, through the righteousness of our God and Savior, Christ Jesus Christ, have received a faith as precious as ours, grace and peace be yours in abundance through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ our Lord. His divine power has given us everything we need for a godly life through our knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. Through these, he has given us his very great and precious promises, so that through them you may participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption of the world caused by evil desires. For this reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness, knowledge, and to knowledge, self-control, and to self-control, perseverance, and to perseverance, godliness, and to godliness, mutual affection, and to mutual affection, love. For if you possess these qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective and unproductive in your knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But whoever does not have them is nearsighted and blind, forgetting that they have been cleansed from their past sins. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, make every effort to confirm your calling and election. For if you do these things, you will never stumble, and you will receive a rich welcome into the eternal kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This would have been the spot where I would have introduced Dr. Terry LeBlanc to our community. Many of you already know Dr. LeBlanc from his work here in the Bachelor of Education program, as well as his work as the director of Tyndale's Indigenous Studies Program. Unfortunately, I can tell from the computer in front of me that he has not been able to join us because of internet issues in Prince Edward Island. So I regret that we will not have him with us today, but we will certainly, as I indicated at the beginning of today's service, be able to receive a recorded message from him, and we will share it with our community as soon as we're able to. So I apologize about this. As Dr. Kerr reminded me on entering the chapel this morning, sometimes technology is our friend, sometimes not so much. So we will have to bear with this today. What I would suggest, however, though, for the next 5 minutes perhaps, in the same manner that we did last week, I would invite you to, in any posture that you're comfortable, or perhaps even uncomfortable, kneeling, standing, sitting, to pray silently in recognition of what we are in the midst of a memory, a recollection, a reflection of the National Day of Truth and Reconciliation. It will be held officially on Thursday, but this week is a week that we can start the process of understanding our history, particularly for those of us who were not the First Nations, and how our presence and our power has influenced what has happened within Canadian history. So I'm going to invite you, and I'll invite myself, to enter into a time of prayer for a few moments, and then we'll conclude with another song from our worship team, and then a benediction. So please join me in prayer. God, in these moments of silence and the bigness of the absence of sound, we are reminded that this space is space that allows us to hear and to listen and to not speak. God, may we be a community that listens well, that hears the cries and voices of our Indigenous brothers and sisters from the Pacific to the Atlantic and up to the Arctic. Men and women who have been through trial and turmoil, and to be frank, abuse, a sense of dehumanization, a marginalization that both our forefathers and mothers, as well as even those of us today, have inflicted upon them. And God, we bow in contrition and with the desire to be forgiven. God, may we be a community that hears those stories, that in the midst of truth-telling and reconciliation-making, that we will be participants in story-sharing, that we will understand with greater ability what has happened, and with wonderful hope what can be before us, because you are our sovereign God. God, in your faithfulness, stir our hearts to be men and women of action and of contemplation, to act where there is injustice, to act where there is false news and lies that are perpetuated. and to be men and women of contemplation as we listen to the stories and then act on those stories for the sake, not only for the sake of our First Nations, for our Métis and our Inuit, but for the sake of all Canadians, for all members of the community. That you will stitch us together again. That the past will be a profound reminder of where we ought not to go. That the present will be a place that we will be able to make amends, to ask forgiveness, and to seek justice. And that the future will be filled with hope. Hope for this community at Tyndale University, hope for our city, our province, and our nation. God, we pray for our Indigenous brothers and sisters today, both within and without the church, that you will comfort them, that your presence will be upon them, that you will give them courage in the midst of calamity. And God, where there is injustice, even as it may be with a lack of drinking water, a lack of appropriate accommodations, or where disease runs rampant, God, may you intervene through us, your ambassadors and emissaries of grace, truth, and life. May we not sit idle. God, for this week, a week of reflection, of memory, we pray that we will be attentive, that our ears will be open, that our hearts will be stirred, that our hands will get dirty for the sake of your kingdom. May this community, Tyndale University, be one of reconciliation, of restoration, of justice. Jesus, we love you, and we are so grateful for your presence even this morning, knowing full well that you are a God of deep compassion and expansive forgiveness. May we know that. May our brothers and sisters know that. And now, God, we pray in the name of Jesus, who gives us all, is faithful and just. Amen.
Let's stand together as we sing these words of, as we say these words in our hearts, this prayer, let the light of God shine on us that we may be saved.
Shine on us, Lord.
Please remain standing as we hear these good words, the benediction. Empower us by your Spirit to love fiercely, to give and receive forgiveness fully, to pray daily, to serve cheerfully, to live simply, and to leave everything else to God. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in peace.